गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू वेल कंप्यूटिंग क्लास. माय नेम इज़ पी सतीश कुमार, वर्किंग असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन चलपति इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी लॉ. टुडेज क्लास इज टुडेज ट्यूटोरियल. सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट GSM. सो GSM मीन्स ग्लोबल सिस्टम फॉर मोबाइल कम्युनिकेशन. सो हियर द GSM is much more than just an acronym of for global system for mobile communication. So this particular GSM is very popular technology in the mobile computing, and it signifies an extreme success technology, and it is a barrier for mobile communication system. Here the GSM today, which covers 75% of all the digital wireless networks. The mobile telephone has graduated from being a status symbol to a useful appliance. People use it not only for business but also in the personal life. That's why the GSM gaining more popularity. So coming to the history of this particular GSM, here the GSM is based on a set of standards which are formulated in the year 1980s. Okay, so here in the year 1980s, in the Conference of European Post Telegraphic, that is CEPT, formed a study group called Group Special Mobile. So what is that called? Group Special Mobile, that is GSM, to study the development of pan-European mobile systems, which was later renamed as a global system for mobile communication. So previously the GSM name is Group Special Mobiles. So after several years, it can be translated as global system for mobile communication. Okay, so after that, so these are the main objectives in order to meet GSM. That is GSM to meet the following business objectives, it has to be invented. That is, the first one is it support for international roaming. It also support for good speech quality. So it has to support international roaming. So your SIM card is from Andhra Pradesh, you can go wherever you want, and you can talk, you can do whatever you want. So whether you might be a call to your friend, or you can able to access some information from the net, you can able to send mails, all these kinds of stuff. Next, coming to the second business objective is good speech quality. Here the good speech quality is nothing but the mobile phone we are using is the primary purpose is for the call only. So we have to talk to our friends or our families with a good proper quality, so it is audible with a quality sound. Next, coming to the third one, it is the ability to support handheld terminals. Okay, so it is the ability to support the handheld terminals. So what is meant by handheld terminals? The handheld terminals are nothing but the PDAs, the palm tops, and the and mobile phones. All these devices come under the palm held device. So this is not intended for the desktops, not intended for the laptops. It is intended for the handheld devices. Okay. Next, coming to the fourth objective, that is business objective, that is it is a low terminal with a service cost. So which is, it has to be a low terminal one, and the service must be a cost. So the GSM services is not working as a free, so for each service there will be a cost. Next, coming to the fifth one, it is a spectral efficiency. So what is meant by spectral efficiency? So whatever the spectrum it is used by the GSM. So the spectrum is whether it is 2G spectrum, whether it is a 3G spectrum. So that must be, it has to be, this particular technology has to be efficiently used that particular spectrum. Next, coming to the sixth one, which supports for a range of new services and facilities. So it will also use it to support the new services, just like mails, chats, WhatsApps, all kinds of things. So next, the final one is the ISDN compatibility. So integrated switching digital network compatibility. So this particular GSM will compatible with this particular ISDN. So these are all the seven business objectives to meet by that particular GSM. Okay. So coming to the timeline, so history about the GSM. in the 1982. So the GSM was established. Here the GSM means not global system for mobile communication. It is the at the time of establishment, the name is the Group Special Mobile. Okay, so Group Special Mobile. So at the year of 1987, it is essential elements of wireless transmission specified. So in the 18, there are some essential elements in the wireless transmission. So those elements are specified in the year 1987. Coming to the third one, that is in 1989, the GSM becomes the ETSA Technical Committee. So the GSM becomes ETSA Technical Committee. Coming to the fourth one, so in the 1990 here, the phase one, the GSM 900 specification are frozen. So in the 1991, the first GSM network was launched. So even though it has discovered in the 1989, but coming to the 1982, so the first GSM network was launched in the after the 9 years, that is 1991. Next, coming to the next one, that is 1993, the first roaming agreement came into effect. Okay, coming to the four, that is data transmission capability launched in the year 1994. In the 1995, the phase two is launched. Phase two means faxing services and SMS and roaming services is offered by the GSM technology. Next, coming to the last one, that is in 2002, SMS volume crosses 24 billions per year, 750 billion subscribers. So this particular in the year of 2002, after it has last launched from 1994, after exactly the 10th year, so the subscribers reached to 750 million. Look at that particular subscribers count. So this shows how the how this particular technology is popular. So this is about the GSM timeline. So we can also call it as a history. Next, in the GSM, we will use the TDMA and FDMA in the GSM. So in GSM, in Global System for Mobile Communication, we use the combination of frequency division multiplexing and time division multiplexing. I hope you guys are know about frequency division multiplexing and time division multiplexing. Okay. So here, the frequency band which is allocated to the particular GSM network is 50 MHz. So the 50 MHz is divided into two parts. One is 25 MHz, another one is 25 MHz. And so the first 25 MHz is for uplink, and second 25 MHz is for downlink. So first 25 MHz, 890, the range of that is the frequency band is from 890 kilo MHz to 915 MHz. That is the first 25 MHz, that is for used for uplink, that is uplink means upload. So second one is 935 to 960 MHz. So that is the second one. Okay, so the second channel, this is for downlink, so downloading purpose. So which is the which has the bandwidth of 935 MHz to 960 MHz. Okay, so this particular GSM will be worked on the bandwidth of 900 MHz frequency band using FDMA. Okay, so first it is the frequency is divided into two channels. After that, each one is divided further divided into 124 channels. So here the 124 channels means the 125 channels, except that one is not used. That's why we are counting that 124 only. Okay, so and each channel carries the bandwidth of 200 kilohertz. Okay, so by using the TDMA, each of the above mentioned channel is then further is divided into 8 time slots. So each the 24, all 124 channels are divided by the FDMA. So and each channel again is divided with the use of TDMA, that is time division multiple access, using 8 time slot, so that the combination of FDMA and TDMA will work, and it has a maximum of 1992 channels for transmit and receive can be realized. Okay, so this is about the use of thing. Next, so we have to consider the frequency reusage in the GSM. So what is meant by a frequency reusage? Here, in order to serve hundreds of thousands of users, the frequency must be reused, and this is done through cells. So we cannot give entire bandwidth for this particular network only, right? So that's why we need to reuse this frequency. Okay, so for reuse purpose, so we will we will divide the area into cells. So that cells concept we will see. Okay, so for reusable purpose, we have the concept called cells. So what is meant by a cell? Now we will see. So the area which is to be covered is divided into radio zones. So the area, for example, in Guntur, Airtel network is there in Guntur. So the Guntur is the whole network. So but the entire network is divided into parts, right? So that is cells. So here the cell means here in my home, that is in Guntur, in Bradipet, there is Airtel tower. So whatever the range, the signals which is transmitted by that particular tower, the radius, so that is called a cell. Okay, so here through in the realistic these cells could be of any type. So we cannot define the shape of the cell in the real time, but for our convenient, so it is modeling purpose, these are modeled as a hexagon. So the cells are modeled as a hexagon. So base stations are positioned at the center of these cells. So here, what is meant by base station? So base stations is nothing but the signaling towers. So in my area, Airtel one tower is there, GR one tower is there, right? So the tower which is called a base station in the mobile computing terminology. So whatever the area that is covered by that particular tower is called a cell. Okay, so simply an area which is covered by that particular base station is called a cell. So coming to the third point here, the each cell receives a subset of frequencies, that is FB. Each cell I, that is I might be a 1 to n. Okay, each cell receives a subset of frequencies, that is FBI, frequency bandwidth of I, from the total set assigned to the respective mobile network. Here, to avoid any type of co-channel interference, two neighboring cells never use the same frequency. So in order to avoid the interference, for example, so if you listen the radio, so the radio have different channels. So suppose 98.3, 101.1, so these are the different channels. For if you tune the radio 98.3 and if you place the another channel in the frequency 98.4, so there is some kind of interference. So the quality of the song is not get properly to listen. So that's why, so we have to avoid the interference. So for that purpose, we need to we never use the same frequency to the neighboring cells. Okay, this is about frequency reuse. Next, here at only at the distance of D, that is known as frequency reuse distance, the same frequency of the set, that is FBI, can be reused. Okay, so suppose the frequency which is used in my area, that is Bradipet. So the adjacent area is what? Bradipet adjacent area, Lakshmipuram, right? So Lakshmipuram, so that's why that particular thing is not the same frequency will not be going to be used in that particular area. So we have to use another frequency. So but where we can use the same frequency which is we used in this particular Bradipet area, so that frequency is reused at another place, for example, old bus stand. Okay, so Bradipet frequency is reused in old bus stand. So which has some distance, right? So cell with the D distance from the cell I can be assigned one or all the frequencies from the set of FBI belongs to cell I. So when moving from one cell to another during ongoing conversation, an automatic channel change occurs. Okay, so this phenomenon is called handover. So when you talk, so I call to my friend when I at home, so and I am continuously calling and moving on my bike. So I am moving from my home to college. Okay, so at that I am I will go through different cells. So but the my call is not disconnected. Okay, so how it is possible? This is possible by using this particular phenomenon called handover. So handover maintains an active speech and data connection over cell boundaries. Next, coming to the regular repetition of frequencies in cells result in clustering of cells. So the clustering generated in this way can consume the whole frequency band. So the size of the cluster, so cluster means the combination of cells is called cluster. The size of the cluster is defined by K, and the number of the cells in the cluster, So this is also defines the frequency reuse at distance d. So the figure next show the cluster of size 4. So this is about the figure. Okay, so here look at this particular figure. In the particular figure we have a cluster, so size of 4. Okay, so if you see any of the things, so if you look at the portion here, so 1 2 3 4, so the cells adjacent the cell which is adjacent, neighboring cells does not have any frequencies, any same frequencies. So one is used here, next afterwards one is used one cell after only, so the distance of d. So look at this, so 4 is used here and the 4 is used after the one cell of distance. So here also after the one cell of distance we can call it as a this as a cluster. So this is about the frequency reuse in the GSM. Okay, so we will discuss the next concept in the next coming class. Thank you all.